Are you dancing with your little brother? Please don't drop him. Khalil, you love him, don't
Look
you?
at this. He's standing. He's standing.
Guess what I have?
What?
Guess what I have?
Report card.
Your report card.
I'm nervous. I've been doing good for the past 3 years.
Right, for English
reading, I got yellow.
Okay, first I need to know what the marks are for.
The marks are
on. So for English reading, Eunice actually did brilliant. He got green. For English writing, Eunice got green for spelling, which is amazing. And then he got handwriting and grammar, orange. Needs some improvement in that area. Eunice's handwriting is. Eunice's handwriting really and truly needs improvement.
Hey, show them.
So for mathematics, Eunice got green. He did amazing.
And mathematics.
Data handling.
And then data handling, he also got green. For science, Eunice got green for physics, biology.
Mommy.
Scientifically.
Yes.
Hold on.
Yes.
And then for social skill, Eunice got green again.
Working
with others, working independently, talking with others, understanding own and others' feeling. That's
yes,
amazing.
Yes.
Okay, mental and health. Eunice.
I'm not mental.
Mental and physical health. Eunice got green again.
Self confidence. Resistance.
Okay, and self caring and fitness.
Let's see, Khalil.
Come on, let's see.
All about Khalil got everything green. Now I deserve to get pancakes.
They really
Wait, let me just look at Khalil quickly.
No, we're gonna reveal it together. Khalil, come. Are you ready? Khalil's report card now. Let's see how he did. For English, Khalil, for reading, he got green. For English writing, spelling, grammar, and handwriting, Khalil's handwriting, you guys, is the most beautiful handwriting that a 9-year-old can
have.
Is
it good?
Basically, it is really, really good.
Nowadays,
I get him to do all my. If I've got papers, I ask him to do it for me.
Okay. He actually does. Hey,
he does.
Hey, you.
Okay, wait. And then for mathematics, Khalil got all green.
Except from fraction,
he needs improvement in fraction.
Data handling is nice.
Data handling, you got absolutely
geometry
amazing.
Geometry is too easy.
He got green. For science, Khalil got all green.
Except
for social skills, he got all green. For mental and physical health, he got all green. So Khalil just with flying colors, like every other year.
Like I did.
Khalil
got
the
same.
Flying colors.
Okay.
Me and Khalil got the same.
Hey, mommy.
Yeah.
Sorry to be mean. You need Vaseline. Your lips are not clean. You smell like cheese. Go to the washing machine.
Sorry to be mean. You need Vaseline. Your lips are not clean.
So as I was saying, I am so proud of these boys. Like, honest to God, they have been working so hard at home. Every morning they would get up and they're on that laptop and ready for their teachers to attend.
Yeah.
You know, they're working really, really hard. They're struggling, you know. It's very hard for children because they're not sitting in front of a teacher and they're not getting that one-to-one communication. I thought they would have struggled, but honest to God, they put their heads down and they tried as hard as they could. And the results in the pudding, sweetheart. I promise you, these boys are such a hard workers. Everything that they do, they put 110% in. Like, they work so hard. And I'm one of their moms. I don't let them get away with anything. If you're not feeling well, take a paracetamol and still get up, you know? I push them to their limit, but they never complain. Like, they never complain. I'm always pushing them. These children will come back from school, come out from mosque, they will go straight to swimming. Khalil would have a football after that. I mean, their whole day is filled with activity. You never see them complaining. So you guys, welcome back to another daily. We made it to another morning, alhamdulillah. Today is going to be a chilled day. Don't know what the day is going to be. I always have my days planned out, but it never goes to a plan. So I'm just not going to tell you guys what the plan is, and we'll just see where the day takes us. Currently, we just opened up the boys' report card. They got flying colors, basically. They got flying colors, so I'm just proud of them there. I'm about to go and make breakfast for these boys. They normally fast until 10 o'clock. They woke up. I normally let them fast until 10 o'clock because they really want to and they want to get involved. So who am I to say no if they can handle it? They're that age where they're able to tell me whether they're hungry or not. So right now, I'm going to make them some egg and a slice of toast with a cup of milk. That's what I'm going to do. What else are we doing for iftar? So for iftar, I don't know what I'm going to be making yet. The two people that are fasting make the last decision on what we eat for iftar. So I'm just waiting for them to make a decision on what they want to eat, and then I'll show you guys what I make for iftar. So Sully just got in.
And I'm about to open the first one. Khalil, your report card, mashallah. I just want to see greens. And wow. Green.
Yeah.
Mashallah. One little orange thing.
Yeah.
Just needs to improve on that one. But to be honest, too many green, wallahi. I'm actually proud of you.
But they, you know how hard they worked, wallahi. They woke up every single morning and sat in front of that laptop and took part in the lesson.
No.
Didn't they? They did really well.
Same thing for you. I'm very impressed, wallahi. MashaAllah.
It was a teamwork.
It was a teamwork, baby.
Can I have my
high five?
Yes, we did well. Our children did well. Iftar time now. So I am going to be making some skinless, boneless bass fillet. That's what we're going to be making today. Fish with a little bit of rice. I feel like we've been having rice every single day now. So hopefully tomorrow I'm going to switch it up so we don't have to have rice. But for today, that's what we're having. It's just my partner who's fasting today. My daughter went over to her cousins, so they're all breaking their fast there, all the little girls, they're all breaking their fast together. So it's just him, we're just preparing dinner for him today. So he just wants something light, so we're going to have some fish, vegetable and rice. My seasoning, I'm going to be using chili and onion and all Chinese spices for fish. I'm just going to drizzle that generous amount. Put a bit of that in there. And then obviously I don't do anything without black pepper. I'm also going to put a little bit of Maggi on there. Drizzle some of this lovely, lovely olive oil on there also. I've decided to make roast potatoes as well, so I'm just going to now pour some hot water. I'm gonna let that, soften just a bit, and then I'm gonna put it in the oven to get that crispy potatoes on the outside, but soft on the inside. They loved the pancake yesterday, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make half a cup of pancake today, add 1 cup of milk. The potatoes have softened up a bit now. I'm going to drain the water and drizzle some olive oil, black pepper, and just season that and put it in the oven. I prepared some green today. We're going for that healthy meal. The pancakes went down a treat yesterday, so we're going to make the pancake again. It feels a bit thick today, not sure why. Oh yeah, by the way, this is how you also make an injera. It should look like this. The potatoes have gone a bit crispy now, just how we wanted. And I've put my fish in because the fish, I'm only going to cook it for 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. What do you have on your plate?
Rice, tomatoes, a fish with salad and cucumber with tomato and veg.
Ooh, yummy. This man doesn't eat anything without banana.
Same as you. Oh.
Right, you guys, that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I do apologize once again because it is quite short, but that's like I said, that's all I can fit in during the day. I'm gonna go and enjoy my dinner with these lot now, so I'll see you guys. Guess what I'm left with? They left me with all of this mess. Now I gotta sort all of this out. Oh my god, the car almost landed on me.